Our theme with Chef Ray today from McCormick and Schmick's is what to do with the pile of leftovers. And we're going to move on to the mashed potatoes, Chef Ray.
Mashed potatoes. Okay. Obviously, one of the leftovers that your mom always used to have was lots of mashed potatoes.
Right.
At McCormick and Schmick's, we like to take our mashed potatoes and do a little twist to them. Mm-hmm. And we make mashed potato cakes.
Okay.
And basically, it's mashed potatoes, eggs, cheese, flour, some salt and pepper, and some seasoning. You can cut ham into there. If you have extra turkey, we could cut that in there too to make it just a little bit more exciting.
So a question for you. So the pan, you've got some oil in the pan, and you just take a big thing of mashed potato and,
You mix it all together
and
then make a little cake, which we've done right here.
Right.
And then we flour and then mix it with a little bit of scrambled egg wash.
Okay,
and
sure.
Then this is panko. Panko's a little bit more crispy than regular Italian breadcrumbs.
Okay.
And then oil, half butter in the pan, and we're quick frying them at medium-high heat for roughly 3 to 4 minutes until they sort of melt on the inside.
So would this be something you'd serve today?
It would be something I'd serve today. I made up a little turkey sandwich with some cranberry mayonnaise, and we'd be having our potato cakes as a side for the turkey sandwich.
But if people are coming in today and they go, so these were the leftovers that you're putting together, I mean, do they get a little wary about the fact that this is stuff from yesterday?
Well, we were so busy yesterday that there weren't any leftover mashed potatoes,
okay.
So we'll be making these fresh today.
So, I mean, you got to be pretty innovative on stuff like this. I mean, do you do this kind of stuff at home too?
Oh yeah,
I
have my leftover projects. It's the only way to make the, you know, stretch your dollar as long as possible.
Right.
So.
We were just talking before the break. What do you think is the best leftover food that's maybe better the next day than the day of?
I love, well, any like turkey. Obviously, turkey sandwiches. We made turkey soup earlier.
Right.
I like sweet potatoes cold. And stuffing, obviously, I'll be eating stuffing for at least 3 days.
I know, stuffing really keeps well.
Yeah.
So that's good. So, you got a menu change coming up? We haven't officially hit winter yet.
Actually, our biggest news for McCormick and Schmick's is open for Christmas, and we'll be opening a Roseville restaurant in February. So.
Oh, no kidding.
We'll be looking forward to that coming out real soon.
Wow. How did you folks do for Thanksgiving?
We had about 400 happy Sacramentans yesterday.
Okay. Did you plan? Did you figure? And that's a tough thing with a restaurant. Businesses, you never know until the day of. You may have a lot of walk-in.
Well, we planned fairly well, and we probably went through 400 pounds of turkey yesterday.
No kidding.
Yeah, that's a lot of Thanksgiving.
Wow. Do you find more and more people are going out just because they don't want to have to deal with all the cleanup, but then you don't get the leftovers the next day that you might normally do if you did it at home?
It's true, but we usually make big enough plates that people can take to go.
Okay.
And for the most part, younger people or families who want to get together that don't want to have the big mess at home would always come into the restaurants. All the McCormick and Schmick's have been open for Thanksgiving for at least 15 years now.
How many McCormick and Schmick's are there now, coast to coast?
There are 95 restaurants.
And you're supposed to know all this stuff, right?
In case
somebody asks you. That's good stuff.
Yeah.
Chef Ray, thank you so much. We do appreciate that. And potato pancakes, certainly. Well, can we call them pancakes? What are we calling them?
Actually, we would call them croquettes.
Croquettes. Very nice. We'll get a final shot of that. Chef Ray, thank you.